Hey everybody, my name is Dr. Carp. I am president and founder of Miracle Noodle, if you do not know, and wanted to do a little bit of an experiment. And in my weight loss group that I have on Facebook, we've gotten a couple of questions about resistant starch. And so I figured I would just jump on Facebook Live, do this as an experiment, and see how it goes. And what we're going to do in today's lecture is talk about resistant starch, what you need to know about resistant starch. And the aim of this lecture is to understand that we all have this delicate balance in our body, especially in our gut, and what the role of resistant starch is for that. I also want to explain to you how to choose resistant starch for your diet, because it has such incredible benefits. And then also to understand why you don't need supplements in this case, that nature basically always, in a sense, has it figured out, and the same thing goes with this particular thing. So what we need to do is think about this as food for your gut, because we have these beneficial bacteria in our gut, and they actually need food. And what's amazing about it is that when they get food, they release other chemicals that have a whole host of amazing properties that affect all kinds of things in our body. And so when we don't have the beneficial bacteria in our gut, if it's not populated in our gut in a good way, then it can affect a whole host of things so far away from the gut. And so when we have this beneficial bacteria in the gut, and then they get the resistant starch, they can then release chemicals called short-chain fatty acids. And when short-chain fatty acids are released, those actually feed the gut lining, and that creates a good gut barrier, as well as it has anti-inflammatory effects in other parts of the body. So what's the story of resistant starch? I mean, how does it work in our body, and why is it so important? Well, first of all, as we've sort of discussed already, resistant starch basically enters the gut. It's then eaten by the beneficial bacteria in our gut, and then that creates chemicals, compounds called short-chain fatty acids that basically feed the gut lining. They also have anti-cancer effects. In fact, in the colon, they actually induce cancer cells to die. And as I mentioned, they have anti-inflammatory effects. But there's this delicate balance, and that's important to understand. You see, you have these good bacteria, and these can be affected by eating too much sugar, alcohol, pesticides, food coloring, antibacterial soaps. All of these things can affect the beneficial bacteria. And if that's not there, then you're not going to be able to create these short-chain fatty acids. So first you need to have the good beneficial bacteria. We need to pay attention to the things that we're doing in modern day life that can affect that. And second, you need to give these beneficial bacteria food. If you don't give them food, they're not going to produce these beneficial chemicals that produce these beneficial compounds. And third, these compounds that are created feed the colonocytes of the colon, the cells that line the gut. And this creates a healthy cell and a healthy gut barrier. So what basically is resistant starch? Starch is basically a chain of glucose molecules, a chain of sugar molecules. When you eat when you eat starch, you have enzymes in your body that basically cut the chains. So it's almost like if you had a chain, a real chain that was linked together. What happens is here's a sugar, here's a sugar, and then we have enzymes that break it apart, and then your body can use these starches. And these are often found in things like potatoes and rice and grains. And most starch is digested, but a small portion is resistant. And that's resistant starch. And we have four types of resistant starch. And so resistant starch one is basically found in cell walls. So basically, it's physically inaccessible, and it's found in minimally processed whole grains, seeds, beans, that sort of thing. And when we always talk about beans, we want to make sure that we cook them properly. We want to enjoy beans, but we want to make sure they're cooked properly, because they contain lectins, which can irritate the gut. And while not everyone is susceptible to this gut irritation from lectins, it's something that we all need to pay attention to. especially if we have autoimmune diseases or other problems with the gut. We need to pay attention to that. Not everyone. Certainly, this was described really well in a recent book by my friend, Dr. Stephen Gundry, in a book called The Plant Paradox. And he happened to have several recipes that included miracle noodles, which we were very happy about that. And that's actually how I met Dr. Gundry. And I spent a day with him in his office and learned so much about so many different things. So that's resistant starch one, found in cell walls. And when you refine grains too much, that is going to basically cause you to have actually more starch. And it's also going to cause your blood sugar to rise. So you want to have minimally processed and foods and also cooked properly. Then we have a resistant starch number two, and this is found in raw potatoes and green bananas as an example. And it's not digestible because it has a crystalline structure. And I don't recommend this as a supplement. And the reason is because, first of all, fruits are not meant to be eaten when they're not ripe. And the reason is because fruits really want you to eat their plant, eat their fruits when they are ripe, because the seeds are ready to spread and to grow another tree. So trees do not create chemicals in the fruits that cause you not to want to eat them. And there's a reason to avoid that. So I don't recommend eating green bananas. Raw potatoes have a poisonous chemical in them. And I don't know if the supplements out there actually reduce this chemical. In fact, I was at a food show and there was a company selling potato starch. And I asked them this very question and they said they weren't really sure if they actually were removing this particular chemical. So I don't recommend that you go out and you buy type 2 resistant starch found in potatoes to sort of, you know, boost the amount of resistant starch that you eat. You want to get it from a wide variety of plants and seeds and nuts, all kinds of different types of fibers. And we'll get into the difference between resistant starch and fiber in just a minute. But you don't need to supplement. You want to, as we discuss in my weight loss group, we want to get a couple, you know, 2 tablespoons of flax seeds per day, a handful of raw nuts, and a large, big salad and some steamed greens per day. If you want to get all that in, you're going to get enough fiber that's really going to have a beneficial effect on these bacteria in your gut. Now, then there's resistant starch 3, and resistant starch 3 is my favorite kind of starch. And the resistant starch, and that's because it's also known as retrograded starch. And retrograded starch is basically when you take a starch like found in my preferred starches, which are white rice and sweet potatoes, you cook them and then you refrigerate them overnight. And this cooking and then refrigerating process creates resistant starch. So you're not going to get as many calories. It's going to blunt the blood sugar rise when you're eating these foods, which is fabulous. And, you know, it allows you to enjoy sweet potatoes and some rice on occasion. You know, a lot of people out there are against all carbohydrates, but there are ways of eating them and incorporating them into your diet so that you get higher percentage of resistant starch, as I'm saying, cooking it and then, you know, refrigerating it. And, you know, I highly recommend that if you want to continue eating sweet potatoes and rice, this is the way you do it. Resistant starch 4 is a modified starch that is made by the food industry, and there's no need to discuss that because obviously you know that I'm not going to recommend that sort of thing. We want to stick to minimally processed foods, lots of greens and properly cooked beans and seeds. And you're getting this into your diet, you're going to get enough variety that the gut bacteria are going to be happy. Then they're going to create those chemicals that are going to have a whole host of effects. And I might mention that while we're just talking about resistant starch, they create all kinds of chemicals. As an example, I recommend that everyone take 2 tablespoons of flax seeds per day. And lignans are not broken down, they're not processed by the beneficial bacteria like this is. In other words, they're not releasing short chain fatty acids, but they are releasing chemicals that can have positive hormonal effects on the body. That's just one example of when you have a situation where another thing, you know, here we're talking about resistant starch, but we're talking about when we're eating a whole host of different plants, you're getting a whole host of chemicals produced. And it's just amazing to me that every single day in the medical literature, we're finding that it's not necessarily the foods that we're eating that contain the end product that's causing so much benefit. It's actually what the beneficial bacteria in the gut are forming or creating in response to eating all of these wide variety of plant fibers from all kinds of different plants. Now, what makes resistant starch different than fiber? Well, the truth is some people consider resistant starch to actually be a type of fiber. But when we talk about, as an example, miracle noodles would be classified as a non-starch polysaccharide, which basically means that though it's not made up of a chain of glucose molecules like I discussed, it actually is made up of a chain, but not just glucose. And it's also resistant to digestion in the sense that it is also forming, allowing the beneficial bacteria to form short-chain fatty acids, which is going to create, as I mentioned, this healthy lining of the gut and creating gut barrier as well as these anti-inflammatory effects and making our gut bugs that are these gut beneficial bacteria happy and continually fed by different things. So that is what I wanted to talk about, resistant starch. And as I mentioned at the beginning of this lecture, the goal of this lecture was basically to discuss the delicate balance of the gut. You know, we've got beneficial bacteria that we need to protect. Then we need to eat different types of fibers, one being resistant starch. And then as a result of that, we get all these incredible chemicals formed that create all kinds of positive health benefits. The second aim was to know how to choose resistant starch. The best way, I think, is to use retrograded starch. And that is where you take a starch, like a sweet, preferable, like a good one, like sweet potatoes, and you cook it and then you refrigerate it overnight. Then you have more resistant starch. And then also the same thing with white rice. You can do the same thing. There was a study done in India where they actually mixed white rice with coconut oil, and they found that in addition to, and then they cooked it and then they refrigerated it. And what happened is that in addition to adding the fat, you got this resistant starch and you had a much lower calorie and blood, and the rice had not as much of a blood sugar elevation effect. That's my favorite type of starch, is to do this sort of retrograded, specifically with sweet potatoes. So now you know how to choose resistant starch. And then also the third was to understand how you don't need supplements. What you do need is to follow what we know about human health and our early ancestors who ate an enormous variety of all kinds of plants and shrubs and berries. And as a result of that, they formed benefit. They were able to feed the beneficial bacteria in their gut to create these beneficial compounds that then have an incredible effect on the body. So that is my lecture on resistant starch. I hope you really enjoyed this. If you liked it, please leave your comments below. And I look forward to doing another Facebook Live with you very soon. This is Dr. Carp, president and founder of Miracle Noodle, and I'll talk to you next time.